Let me please to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Colonel. You may be seated. It is an honor to introduce to you the Executive Director for Florida Department of Veterans Affairs and retired Army Colonel Mike Pendergrass, who will introduce Governor Scott.
Thank you, Liz, and thank you, teammates, for making this facility beautiful today. Governor Scott, Colonel Rooney, Chaplain, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this afternoon's ceremony in beautiful Fort Myers, Florida. It's great to be here and see so many friends and see some of our law enforcement colleagues that are out here as well that have had a privilege of serving with in the past. My special thanks goes out to the great support from the Florida National Guard soldiers who have helped make this facility such a remarkable venue for today's ceremony. Many of these troops just came back from a long deployment for their annual training over in Louisiana, and they've doubled down their efforts to make sure it was ready for a first-class ceremony this afternoon, so we really appreciate you. You've done exceptionally well. Keep doing the great things. You're all good. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks to the hard work of Governor Scott, members of our legislature who are in attendance with us here today, and those who couldn't be with us, members of our cabinet, Florida is the most veteran-friendly state in the country. And that's a great tribute to our veteran community. Today we are here to honor our great troops, our veterans, and our National Guardsmen who hail from the Fort Myers community. And through selfless service and sacrifice, America remains the land of the free.
Amen.
And yet, these men and women, these brave patriot veterans who are with us today, will all tell you to the person that they were not seeking fame or glory when they served and wore the cloth of our nation. When they answered the call to duty, they wanted to be part of something bigger than themselves. As we all know, all gave some, and some gave all. As many of us in this room know, a veteran is a person who at some point in his or her life wrote a blank check made payable to the United States of America for any amount, up to and including his or her life. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the essence of America and the cloth that binds this great country together. It is now my pleasure and honor to introduce to you the son of a World War II paratrooper, a United States Navy veteran, a proud veteran supporter, and the governor of the great state of Florida. Ladies and gentlemen, Governor Rick Scott.